found this car in Coeur d'Alene, Idaho. It was in decent shape, low mileage. I bought the car in 2011. I finished it in the spring of 2013. The visual aspect of the car, the city seals, all of those things are dead nuts on. They are the way they were supposed to be. They're just exactly what was rolling around in Los Angeles in 1957. And that was my goal, was to create what was really there, to be exacting in the creation of it, and to the degree that it was possible. That includes having the correct lights, the correct siren, the correct radios, the correct interior. This is the original radio. The poverty model only had one horn, where most of them had two, but that is a belligerent horn.
Oh my God.
Yeah,
yeah, that,
that's,
well,
that's your eardrums on that movie.
So how did you get this sticker? Was this on the car? Did you have to buy it?
I had to buy them. So this is authentic. It's just the very same thing that were on the cars. And another little point, people say, well, it doesn't say protect and serve. Well, that's because that didn't come until 1963.
These never had air conditioning.
No.
New.
So they were driving
base,
around the valley at 105
yeah,
degrees.
Absolutely.
In wool black uniforms.
On the back window is a sticker that says LAPD Reserve needs you. And it's a Madison phone number. It's a 6-digit phone number. We didn't have 7 digits yet. So it's authenticated at the deepest level. And I'm proud of that. The engine in this car actually came out of another 57. I took the second 57, which was identical to this one, and I cannibalized it for the things to make this one the best car. It's a 223 cubic inch motor. The Ford 6 was way underrated in my opinion, and I based that, first of all, on the street racing I did with one. You know, sorry folks, but you know, I was a 50s kid. And I put down a lot of V8s with that 6-cylinder motor because you can wind it up.
Over 70% of all the cars operated by the nation's state police today are Fords. And no wonder, nobody outperforms Ford.
The department bought them because price, economy, and they test them for performance first. They don't buy cars that won't meet the need on the street. The Ford did it. Well, I've got decals where they belong, you know, for the All the accessories are all marked with the correct stuff here. Decals for the air cleaner. And this is a 1-year only air cleaner, by the way, but just 57 had that style. The stupid battery cost me like $450.
Is it vintage era?
No, they didn't have such a thing in 57. Now, the look of it is vintage. That was the point. With respect to these very rare license plates, can you drive around with them? The answer is no. The car with just those on it is viewed as not licensed, and also the private citizenry can't drive around with exempt plates. Well, those license plates, I was on eBay one day and I go, holy crap, those are the same series 93 that's in that picture I showed you of the original LAPD car. And I'll tell you what, I burned a trail through the house to get to that computer and buy those things. And the fact that they were mint, basically uncirculated, was unheard of. The license number is just 174 digits off from these. And LA owned over 500 of these, so it's highly likely those plates belong to the city of Los Angeles. You've got a genuine LAPD flashlight, says property, city of Los Angeles, LAPD on it. You've got a bullhorn, a megaphone that works. There is a first aid kit that's a period correct first aid kit. There's a fire extinguisher that's dated January of 57. There's the Motorola portable that I'm talking about. That screw the antenna on top. It's a VHF transceiver. You've got a book in there. It's a 1956 version of the city municipal code. Everything to be as real as possible. When you turn the radio on, you get your green indicator there. If you were talking on the microphone, you press the button and the red light comes on. That data plate on the radio, most people have never even seen one. I had to have 250 of them made to get one, because that's what the minimum order for the factory to reproduce the thing was. Yeah, the 2L49 were on scene of the 459.
We haven't decided, code 3, from Duncan Winchell's Yum Yum.
There's your radio calls. The car is numbered for the West Valley Division. And the reason for that is because that division opened in 57. So what comes over that radio now are LAPD calls relevant to the West Valley And then I edited all of these transmissions to eliminate anything that could not have existed in 1957.
Suspects, female Hispanic, and the one's wearing a black jacket, light blue-colored shirt and jeans.
That's me.
She's wearing a dark hoodie.
In this car on the passenger side, there's a button in the floor. That's for the siren, for the second officer to operate the siren, because the driver's busy shifting gears and trying to wheel that no power steering car around. So this is the last car that the city ever owned that was in regular patrol with a stick shift. And the car represents a bygone era. I consider these cars tribute cars. I've been a longtime LAPD fan, and it's paid off handsomely because the LAPD people fell in love with that car, especially when we took it out to the West Valley. And those officers spent probably close to 2 hours playing and having fun and shooting videos and taking pictures and running the siren and talking on the microphone and just reliving the past.
What's this? Do you have a nickname?
Does it or do I?
Both.
Depends on who's asking. No, I got no nickname for it. To me, it's always been the LAPD car, you know. So I'm comfortable that it's gone to a good home. That's big.
In performance, Ford goes first. Test drive a new Ford and prove it to yourself.